Let's all play What's My Line? And now, let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, that popular host of that popular match game, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much. And I want you to meet a good-looking, blonde, brainy lady. Here is Dr. Joyce Brothers.
And here's a handsome leading man, star of Broadway, Jack Cassidy.
Thank you, Dr. Brothers. It's my pleasure to introduce to you a lady who's brought fashion, femininity, and frolic to the home tubes, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now let's welcome Mrs. Bruner's darling little boy, Wally.
Thank you, Arlene, and welcome to What's My Line. During the next 30 minutes, you're going to meet some interesting people engaged in the most unusual occupations, which we hope will baffle this panel of experts. And in addition, the panel will face a mystery celebrity guest just a bit later on. But now, panel, you ready to begin?
Yes, here we go.
Ready.
Okay, let's meet our first challenger. Would you enter and sign in, please? Paul Francis. Mr. Francis, may I inquire as to where you're from?
London.
London, England. Very good. Panel, I'll tell you that before Mr. Francis settled on his present career, he had a number of others. He was an exercise boy for a riding stable, a cook in a restaurant, and for 7 years he was a hairdresser in a beauty salon. Later he took up the bongos and drums and played with many big bands throughout Europe. Now we come to his present occupation. He deals with a product, and let's show the audience just what his line is. May I remind you, please, that Mr. Francis is salaried, there's a product involved, and let's begin with Miss Francis.
Thank you. Mr. Francis, we're not related, are we?
No.
No, I'm sorry about that. Is this a product that I might use?
Yes.
Might men use it as well?
Yes.
Is it a product that I could hold in my hand?
No.
That's one down. Gene Rayburn.
In using the product, Mr. Francis, does it come in contact with the body?
Yes.
You mean other than the hands, Gene?
Yes.
Then you get a no, and that's two down. Joyce Brothers.
You tricked me.
Mr. Francis, when you use this product, do you move it around in any way?
No. Well, in a loose way.
In a sense.
Is it large enough to be taller than the person?
Yes.
Sometimes.
Is it large enough to get into?
No.
That's three down. Jack Cassidy.
Mr. Francis, the product you deal in, is it mobile?
Yes.
You mean...
Yes?
Is that an essential part of this particular product, the fact that it may or may not be mobile?
No, I didn't establish if it was essential, but...
You mean, is it a product that's possible to move from
yes.
place to place? It's possible.
It's possible. But one is more likely not to move it. The product that you deal in, is it in any way concerned with the outdoors as opposed to indoors?
No.
That's four down. Arlene.
Is it a product that would be found in a home?
Possibly.
But I think under likely circumstances, Arlene, this is not a product that you would find in the average home. So with your permission, Paul, I'm going to give Arlene a no on that and go on to Gene Rayburn. That's five down, Gene.
Is there anything therapeutic connected with this product, Mr. Francis?
No.
No.
That's six down. Dr. Brothers.
Would this product be used in the world of sports?
No.
No. At seven down, Jack Cassidy?
Is it a product that is sold on the market to a consumer?
Yes.
In a sense, yes.
In a sense. If I were to avail myself of your product, would I have to come to you to... yes. What were you going to say, Jack?
What were you going to ask?
Yes. You would not bring the product to me. I would have to come to you.
Yes.
I see. Do you in any way demonstrate the product?
Possibly.
Not really, I don't believe. Let me give you a small clue, panel, and tell you that our guest is working on Paradise Island in the Bahamas. Arlene?
Ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha. Does your product have anything to do with gambling, Mr.
Yes.
Francis? Does it have anything to do with the tables?
No.
The gaming tables?
No.
That's nine down. Gene Rayburn.
I assume the gaming tables would include roulette. Is that correct?
Yes.
Does it...
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, 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 oh.
Does it have anything to do with the ocean?
No.
That's 10 down, and that means that Francis has won the game. Does anyone have
a slot machine?
Yes. Panel, may I tell you that Mr. Francis repairs slot machines, and he works for the Paradise Island Casino on Paradise Island in the Bahamas. And after such a varied career, how did you end up as a slot machine repairman?
Well, I originally came to the Bahamas, it was 5 years ago, as a croupier, and went to work for the Paradise Island Casino in Nassau. And they needed people to go to learn slot machines. And I went to Chicago, went and worked on the line. And after 6 weeks, I came back to Nassau and sank or swam on the machines.
Well, can you really change the percentage?
Yes, it's possible to change the percentage.
Joyce?
Can I ask about how often the big jackpot comes up?
Any number of times it can be pulled, or you can get a big jackpot every 2-3 minutes, depending. There's no special time that a jackpot will fall into place.
What kind of... Oh, excuse me.
I'm sorry, but there is no percentage. In other words, you wouldn't say someone has to somewhere have 100 tries or 200 tries or 500 tries.
The percentage is set by the amount of symbols on the reels as to when it falls.
The percentage is set by those fellas that own those machines.
Well, no, it's really mathematical.
Is it?
Strictly.
Yes.
I know a person that once wrote his thesis on the elements of chance, of holding a toothpick up and letting it fall, and it will fall so many ways, the percentage can be predicted.
What do you win, a lot of toothpicks?
You win a lot of toothpicks. What is the percentage of payoff generally set?
I would say normally 80-20. The house takes out 20.
In other words, if you stand and play a slot machine for 24 hours, you're going to lose 20 cents out of every dollar.
Yes.
And well, don't stay there for 24 hours.
That isn't too encouraging. You go up and you pull it once and hope for the best. How would you play it, Paul, if you were going to play a slot machine?
I would just keep playing. Knowing my machines as I know the machines, I would probably stay on certain type of machines. Like a 5-coin machine, which you have to pay 5 coins to put in, but you pull the handle once, but your jackpot has increased 5 times.
How large are the jackpots on the biggest jackpots you have?
Well, we have some machines that pay $500 jackpots. We have other machines that can go up to $999.
Is it ever set so that when a man has just won a jackpot, that the next pull will also win a jackpot?
I've seen it happen, Joyce.
It is possible,
yes.
It
can happen.
It has
possible. I've seen it happen.
Very interesting. Well, now we're all expert slot machine players. Thank you, Paul. We enjoyed having you on What's My Life? We'll be back to meet another challenger as What's My Line continues. Oh, we were off to a fairly good start on the 11th question, or on really the 11th no, we guessed that one. Let's see how we do on the next. Would you enter and sign in, please? Alice Schiller. And Alice Schiller, may I ask where you're from, please?
Hollywood.
Hollywood, California?
Yes, sir.
Well, welcome to New York. Panel, may I tell you that Alice Schiller is self-employed and deals in a service. But now let's show the audience just what that service is. May I remind you, panel, that Alice is self-employed, it's a service, and let's begin with Gene Rayburn.
Alice, do both men and women use this service, or can they?
No.
No.
That's one down, Joyce Brothers.
Would this service be performed for animals?
No.
That's two down, Jack Cassidy.
Miss Schiller, is your service confined to the male species?
No.
No. That's three down. Arlene.
What else is there? Oh, women.
Oh. Shoot for that crowd.
Do women use your service?
Yes, they do.
Uh-huh. Does it in any way have any relationship to the entertainment world?
Yes.
Do you do something for women in the entertainment field?
Yes.
You yourself, I take it, are not the performer. You either do something for someone or show them how to do it.
Yes.
Do you show them how to do it?
Yes.
Do you have anything whatsoever to do with the way ladies look?
Well, somewhat.
In a sense, she may have something to do with how they look. However, that is not a basic part of the particular thing that she does.
Do you operate something?
Yes.
You mean something?
Does she handle some product in her work?
No.
No. That's four down, and we go to Gene Rayburn.
That was kind of strange.
Wasn't it?
You got a yes and then a no instantly.
Well, that's the name of the game.
Is this a physical thing, this service?
Yes.
And would the ladies who perform this thing you teach them how to do, would they get a little dewy?
A little dewy?
A little perspiry. I didn't want to use the word.
Yes.
Well, they could.
Yeah. And would they eventually do this in front of a motion picture camera?
They could.
They could.
They could. Oh-ho. Does it have anything to do with the losing of weight?
No.
No, that's five down and Joyce Brothers.
Miss Shirley, you teach people something, teach women something?
Yes.
Do you, does it have something to do with movement? Do you teach them any kind of movement?
Yes.
Would it be in the area of walking or exercise?
No.
No. Six down, Jack Cassidy.
I have to confine, I have to shoot for a specific. Your service, is it in any way part of the water?
The water?
Yes.
No.
I mean, one, yes.
At seven down, Arlene.
Does it have anything to do with the art of self-defense? Or
no.
That's eight down, Gene Rayburn. I thought Gene would get this the first thing.
Really? That's a little clue, is it? Does it have anything to do with lovemaking?
No.
Kissing and stuff like that.
That's nine down. Joyce Brothers.
I've been so involved with Gene's question, it's hard to think of one.
Kiss me.
Do you touch the person in any way?
No.
No, not really. That's 10 down. Does anyone have a guess?
I have a thought. Do you have something to do that in what you teach a woman, does it help her in relationship with a man?
Sometimes.
Specifically? I see.
Anyone have a guess?
Driving, stunt driving of automobiles.
Let me tell you that Ellis Schiller teaches striptease dancing.
I'd like to see her striptease without any movement. I asked about movement and said they would said no.
Did we lead her wrong?
You stand still?
Well, sometimes you...
Did.
did.
Well, so, okay, slow. One black mark for us. But let me tell you that Alice teaches striptease dancing and is the dean of the Pink Pussycat College of Striptease Dancing in Hollywood, California. How about that? And what are the requirements for admission to your college?
Well, they have to be over 21. They have to have a high moral character. And they have to be very serious about the art of striptease. And, of course, a voluptuous body.
A voluptuous body. I think that part is
very
essential.
Sounds like all my attributes.
What degree do you give when they graduate from the Pink Pussycat College?
I'm glad you asked that, Joyce, because I understand that after they graduate, this is really all they need, period. It's all in this little box.
Two feathers?
Well, and plus some very small things that are... It's called the stripper's kit. But you have something else, and may I show them?
Yes, please do.
This is what they also get upon graduation. This
oh,
is the,
I love that.
This is the sweatshirt, and it says the Pink Pussycat, the Naval, N-A-V-E-L, Academy of the West.
Thank you.
When they have their graduation ceremonies, do they put it on or take it off?
Both. But I tell you what, Alice, why don't you present to our two ladies on the panel, the sweatshirt to one and the stripper's kit for the other, and we'll just have to see how things turn out. And thank you for joining us on What's My Life. And we'll be back to meet our mystery guest as What's My Line continues. Now, panel, it's that very special part of What's My Line when we meet our mystery guest. Are the blindfolds in place?
Yes, right sir.
All right, mystery challenger, would you enter and sign in, please? As you can tell by that tremendous reception, our mystery guest has arrived and is seated beside me. I'll remind you, panel, it's one question at a time. I'll give you 2 minutes to try and establish our guest's identity. And let's begin the questioning with Dr. Joyce Brothers.
Would I know you from the movies?
Perhaps.
Jack Cassidy.
Do you presently have a television series? Running?
No.
Arlene Francis.
But have you appeared? Are you known for your appearances on television?
Yes.
Gene Rayburn.
Are you now or have you ever appeared on Broadway?
Yes, ever.
I would say that our mystery guest has appeared on Broadway, but this is not primarily the thing he is best known for. Joyce Brothers.
You have a beautiful voice, and obviously you appeal to the women. Are you a singer?
Yes.
Jack Cassidy.
Have you ever done a film for Walt Disney?
Yes.
Oh, really? Arlene?
I think so.
Well, are you appearing at the present time in a hotel or club in New York?
Almost.
Gene Rayburn.
What is it? Would you clarify the last answer,
well,
please?
Well, perhaps he has not opened quite yet, but will be very, very shortly.
I see. Do you have a current hit record?
No. I wish I did.
Nobody has, Gene.
15 seconds. Joyce Brothers.
Is the Walt Disney picture a recent one?
Fairly.
Okay, Jack?
I think I know who it is. Shall I take a stab?
Yeah.
Are you big, tall, handsome, smashing baritone? Are you a gentleman named John Davidson?
Yes.
I should have known.
I think this is very interesting because as we were standing backstage, John mentioned to me, he said, you know, Jack Cassidy is really my idol.
And I don't think he could.
I should have known old Jack could catch me.
Old Jack?
Well, that's an affectionate term, Jack. That's like saying my old buddy, you know.
You did say O-L-E and not O-L-D.
When I sat down here, I didn't know what to think because in front of me, it says admission requirements, over 21, high moral characters, voluptuous body.
You have to wear the rhinestone that's in my kit in your navel if you want to follow that.
Oh, did she give you that, Doctor?
Yes.
Oh, John, but what is even more interesting, courses of instruction, psychology of inhibitions, and controlling the structural components of the anatomy. But nonetheless,
I'm sorry to hear about Flynn closing. I love the song from the show, though.
Why can't I walk away?
Why can't I walk away?
It's dead wrong for your voice, John. But
no, it isn't.
A lovely song.
I'll look forward to your next show.
You're at the Persian Room, right?
Yes, we open. We're almost opening now, I guess, when the show airs.
Right. You like the live performances opposed to TV and records?
Much better. Yes, I would much better. I would much rather be performing on Broadway as Jack or in a nightclub rather than television, I think.
Well, you've picked a good spot. It's the swank Persian Room of the Plaza. John Davidson, thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Wally.
John Davidson. What's My Line? We'll continue right after this message. And that's it for today. The panel was so good, they're invited back tomorrow, and I hope you'll join us, too, on What's My Line?